In 1891, Thomas Edison patented the kinetoscope, opening the door to a brand new form of entertainment. The first person to try to synchronize film and sound was Thomas Edison himself.
In 1894, Dixon, one of the assistants who worked for Thomas Edison, actually filmed a sound film where the sound was on a cylinder.
It's an incredible piece of motion picture art. It's the earliest sound movie in existence. And what you have is W.K.L. Dixon playing the violin into a recording horn. And that's leading to the phonograph that's making the cylinder.
The kinetophone combined two of Thomas Edison's greatest inventions, the kinetoscope and the phonograph. In theory, a simple idea.
The original kinetophone process was basically just non-synchronous cylinder recordings being played back to accompany a film with music or dialogue or speaking that had something to do with what you were watching, but it wasn't a true synchronous sound film. The improved kinetophone process that Edison introduced in 1913 was a whole different thing altogether.
I am the Queen of the Fairies, and I'm going to cast a spell over the giant, a spell of joy and entertainment.
It was a bizarre contraption. You had a phonograph on one end, you had a camera on the other end, connected by string, with stanchions holding up the string. You had an operator at one end and an operator at the other end, all making hand signals at each other, and each hoping that they're going to start at the same time.
And on a good night, it might work, but most of the time, it didn't.
Technology was causing lots of problems. It was a little bit of an embarrassment for the Edison Company, and finally, Edison said, enough. I'm not getting anywhere with this, and they dropped it.
Sound film had defeated the world's greatest inventor.